I would have never invited Ben Shapiro to campus. Never. He was invited by students. He was funded by students. He was supported by students. I would have never invited anybody like Ben Shapiro to campus.
And this is kind of this ongoing conversation about the specificity of anti-blackness. And that's, I think, what we see with Ben Shapiro. So even if you decided you're going to let this neo-Nazi on campus, right? And I get he's Jewish, so that's ironic that I'm calling him a neo-Nazi, right? But that's basically what he is, the equivalent, a neo-KKK member, let's call him that, right? Because what I'm hearing is students come into my office and feeling traumatized, right? Feeling brutalized, physically, emotionally, and mentally.
Shouldn't we think about a kind of policy or process or set of criteria that the students get behind and say for future events, for us to, as a student body, because this was, you know, these were student groups, this was our student government, right? For us as a student body to support an event, it's gotta have these elements and sort of get that out there. So I think that process, to my mind, I don't know what the result would be, but I think that process would be healthy for us.
Are any other future events going to be allowed by this group, or are what's gonna happen if they decide to throw another event?
Well, you know, that's the question on my mind. It really is. I mean, what do we do next time? And I'm convinced that there will be a next time. I mean, very tragically and unfortunately, we're in a kind of climate nationally and locally in which this kind of provocation is occurring. So.
Yes. In the likely event that the young man gets freedom by another guest, such as Ben Shapiro, how do you intend the prevention of weapons coming onto campus, such as the gun that did come onto campus?
Well, I don't know what you're, are you thinking we should have like a screening process or something?
I'm not sure.
Do you have an idea? I'm not sure either. I think